we can find out about the second derivative of that pi. So let's find g double prime.
These two.
We need to use the quotient rule, so low.
Get a negative one down there, so that's the second thing.
D pi, that is the cosine.
Two.
Minus pi. D low, that's the negative sign. Got an x right there.
Negative two.
Over two plus cosine of x.
That's going to be two divided by three, it's going to be negative two.
So, oh, this is multiplied together. So we have two cosine plus cosine squared x plus sine squared x.
Are these changing colors?
Yes.
Yeah, no.
Agreed so far?
All right.
Yes.
Okay.
Cosine x. I forgot to write an x in there. How about cosine squared plus sine squared? What's that?
One. Just
one. So two cosine x plus one over two cosine x plus cosine x squared. Well, that's pretty simplified. What's really asking us, the value of g prime, g double prime of pi is, it looks at our negative, positive, or equal to zero. Just plug pi in here. What's the cosine of pi? Yeah. So negative two plus one over two plus negative one squared. Negative one over one squared, so negative one. So it's negative. So it's negative, so it's concave down. We have a zero slope, it says right here, so it must be a maximum. Nothing to go to, because that was just, that might have been yours, like it was taken from problems that